We have traveled long and hard to get to this location. This is the birthplace of the blues, right here. Dockery Farms, this is where everything happened, right here.
This is where it all began, at Dockery Farm. In 1895, Will Dockery owned 40 square miles, and he hoped one day it would be a successful plantation, but at the time it was not. Eventually it did become a booming cotton mill, and one of the best examples of Mississippi Delta plantation architect of the 20th century. Many blues legends, including B.B. King, believe that Dockery Farms is the birthplace of the blues. Even though there's no certainty to this, African Americans who came to Dockery Farms to cultivate cotton created a culture through their work in the fields and inspired music that we know as the blues. Dockery Farms was home to legendary godfather Charlie Patton and Henry Sloan, who taught most of the musicians how to play. It was also home to other famous bluesmen as Robert Johnson, Henry Sloan, Son House, and Howlin' Wolf, all played at this plantation. So a lot of people want to know about the story about Robert Johnson. Did Robert Johnson actually sell his soul to the devil at the crossroads? And the real crossroads is only about 3/4 to a mile away from this location. Bluesmen would travel up and down Highway 61 to juke joints to play their own personal style of the blues. Robert Johnson, as a boy, was considered to be a very good harmonica player between the ages of 15 and 16, and would fill in between the acts. The problem was Robert wanted to play guitar. And Robert, you see, was a horrible guitar player. His father even told him to leave and not come back until he could play the guitar. Robert left home. Now, some people believe that Robert Johnson's journey led him south to the crossroads, where he then made a deal with the devil. And how would you make a deal with the devil? You'd get there before midnight with your guitar and play a song. The devil would come up, take your guitar and tune it, give it back, and then you would become a blues legend. Other people have another idea of how this story might have went, and it goes like this. Robert befriended a gentleman named Ike Zimmerman in a juke joint in nearby Beauregard, Mississippi. He was impressed how well he could play, and he asked Ike to help him. Ike was known to practice at night in the cemetery so he wouldn't wake the dead. It is said he practiced with Ike for 6 months to a year, and when he finally returned, the people could not believe that this was the same Robert Johnson who had left just earlier in disgrace. When you leave Dockery Farms, head south right across the highway to the legendary crossroads. This is the location that if he did sell his soul, this is it. And what I want to tell you is, it's pretty creepy. And I tell you what, do I believe that maybe this possibly could be some place that was supernatural? I felt pretty weird here. So again, for any of you wannabe musicians who don't want to practice in the cemetery of all places, you might want to come right up here to this intersection. You're going to be here at midnight, a little before, so you can have your guitar ready, playing your greatest riffs. And then a man, a large man, is going to come crossed out of the darkness. Now, the voice that I heard said he comes from the south across the bridge. Whether that's true or not, I don't know. He will come up to you and he'll ask to have your guitar, and you hand it to him. He will tune it, most likely if you're a musician, maybe in drop D. You will have then traded your soul for the ability to play music. So then what happened to Robert Johnson as he left here with all the skills needed to become a superstar? Well, he started playing the juke joint circuits and he became unbelievably popular. He was also a good-looking man, which was not always the best. He was told at a very young age that when a woman comes up and says, "Play it again, Daddy," and becomes friendly, walk on because they're not going to help you out. So what happened to Robert Johnson's career? Johnson recorded 29 songs between 1936 and 1937 for the American Record Corporation, which released 1178 RPM records during Johnson's lifetime and one after his death. Songs have obtained legendary status. Crossroad Blues, Love in Vain, Hellhound on My Trail, I'll Dust My Broom, Walkin' Blues, and Sweet Home Chicago. Johnson sharpened his skill in the juke joints and on the corners, and he rambled up Highway 61. He went from an awkward boy to a ladies' man. It is said that he was poisoned by a jealous husband, and it took him 3 days to die. Robert Johnson died on August 16, 1938. He was buried in Greenwood, Mississippi at the Mount Zion Church, and you can visit him now. Now, other legends are that he was buried in other locations, which just brings on more of the supernatural. As a matter of fact, Keith Richards said he likened the Blues King guitar playing to a work of the classic composer Bach. And it is a lot easier to say that he just sold his soul. Some people believe the devil came back for that soul. Now, one of the things that is unique and interesting is a lot of his lyrics played in to the devil. And also, this truly was the start of rock and roll, and also a start of the 27 Club. You see, Robert Johnson was the first member of the Rock and Roll 27 Club, and that's a whole nother video. If you love music, you have to go see the Crossroads and Dockery Farms and then go visit Robert, or you really haven't felt the blues.